Current athletes and individuals suffering from brain diseases are tapping into a new technology developed here in our region to better monitor their brain performance. The startup is called RC21X, and it's partnering with researchers from the University of Texas at Arlington to adapt cutting-edge research into a mobile application called Roberto. The app goes beyond concussion testing to provide insights into a broad spectrum of brain performance. Clarence Carlos is chairman and CEO of RC21X, and Dr. Paul Nussbaum is chief clinical officer, and welcome. Good to see you.
Thanks, Bill.
Good to see you again. We had you here a little over a year ago when you were kind of getting this venture just off the ground.
Yes, Bill, and thank you very much. And a lot of stuff has happened since then, and we're at our app version now where you can have it done on your phone. And we're producing some artificial intelligence that's unbelievable, and people are able to monitor their brain performance and brain health on a daily basis, and it takes 6 minutes less than doing the clinical version.
Wow. So, Dr. Nussbaum, exactly how does this technology work?
So, as Clarence indicated, it provides us a really unique opportunity to get the consumer engaged so that we're not reactive like we are so much in our healthcare system in the United States of America. The other thing it does is it puts the brain front and center, which it really deserves to be, Bill. And so, as Clarence said, with the app now, with about 6 minutes, we can really track a lot of information on the individual. The individual can get engaged and try to understand, how is my memory doing today? How are my thinking skills going? What's my reaction time like? And when you do that over time, the individual is able to compare him or herself over time and get a sense of, you know, how am I doing? I started a new lifestyle kind of program. I'm exercising more now. I'm sleeping better. Does it have any impact on my thinking abilities? That is not occurring anywhere else in the United States right now.
And you can actually see that? I mean, you're eating better, you're sleeping better, and it'll show up in how your thinking gets better?
They got a great colored profile, Bill. It's wonderful. It's great data coming back at you. And that's what consumers like. I'm wearing a Fitbit right now. And this tracks certain things, and it kind of changes my behavior a little bit. It makes me conscious of things. So Clarence has done a great job in RC21X and now the app of putting the brain front and center, making us conscious of, you know, we can actually improve our thinking skills, but we got to work at it a bit.
Okay, so this is good for, is not necessarily then people with, say, Alzheimer's or an athlete who's dealing with a concussion issue. This could be of value to just the regular person who just wants to think a little sharper, huh?
Exactly right, Bill. It could be a value add to large health plans, people that are just used to tracking and monitoring how they're doing. If you wear a Fitbit, like Dr. Nussbaum says, and you may not have any health issues, you may just want to see how you're doing on a daily basis. And from doing that, we've been able to team up with a lot of other organizations where we could tie our data into the Fitbit, Apple Health, Google Health, and now work with some companies like G Medical and Aprisma.
So what's your sort of been your growth trajectory so far?
Just building the business. Just in the app, we've been able to. We're getting downloads in over 140 countries now.
Really?
So yeah, we're getting them in Dubai. We're getting Italy. We're getting them everywhere. China. People really like the app. So we're also.
There's no language barriers though, because it's like a game-based system. Isn't
it? Yeah. English is you know, it's everywhere in the world. Yeah, it's ubiquitous. And we're now doing Mandarin. So we're going to change our app into Mandarin. We teamed up with a company out there called G Medical, which is also an Australian, it's Israeli technology, and we're going on to the phone companies there where they're monitoring other vitals in the body from EKG to your blood pressure, pulse, oxygen, your glucose levels. Now they want to know and give that to the client of how's my brain doing? That certain things are changing in my health, and knowing that, hey, the brain is the center of your overall health and most important organ. How is it doing now that these things are doing different things, and what kind of technology or what kind of artificial intelligence data that we can grab off of that?
Well, and will it kind of let you know, here's different things and behaviors you could change to maybe make your brain do a little better?
So we tie lifestyle to it. We provide the consumer with some information about some things to do with regard to eating and exercise, and there's a whole lifestyle approach. A lot of that I've been very busy with over the past 20 years. You raised something really important. This is something Clarence and I talk a lot about. I'm a clinician, Bill, in Western PA. By the time someone with fairly established Alzheimer's disease gets to my office. They've had the disease about 6 years. At that point, we really have our hands tied. Yeah. And so one of the things Clarence and I talk almost every day, I've said, man, it would be really good if we could get out ahead of this, if we could get folks tracked from literally childhood on. And so you have these numbers across your lifespan, so everybody has their own normative profile. That really helps the clinical field. First of all, it helps the consumer, but most, and secondarily, then it helps someone like me, because we can get involved a lot earlier if we think something's going awry.
Sure.
We don't have that right now.
There's no way, no other mechanism really established that.
There's really not.
Track.
The greatest healthcare system in the world, we're really still reactive. We're too reactive. This really positions us to be proactive.
Fascinating. Yes. So if somebody wants to download it and get involved and start tracking their progress, how do they find it?
They go to www.robertoapp.com.
Robertoapp.com.
Yes.
Fitting enough, RC21. I get the Pittsburgh
yes.
connection here.
Roberto Committee. Connection. That's it. Yeah.
Fitting absolutely that this is all happening here in our region. Clarence Carlos and Dr. Paul Nussbaum from RC21X.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks so much. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Paul.
Next up, why the money thing is all the talk at Point Park University and what it's teaching students about personal finance. We'll be right back.